the whole edifice is beginning to crumble. There's chaos. The money's running out. You are very, very dangerous people indeed.
And they want to put their assets to work to help save the world.
A subject which I shouldn't raise, which is going to be one which I think is now time to put on a higher awareness. My wife and I were in London on the night before the Trooping of the Colour, and we had friends for dinner, and we went to the restaurant and met them for dinner. In the course of dinner, with our guest, who is the chairman of a very prominent and highly successful and reputable British FSA-controlled financial institution, and to explain to the House as a whole, as I don't think they have any knowledge, and I'm sorry the Noble Lord Strathclyde is not with us at the moment, because this deeply concerns him also. But for the last 20 weeks, since yesterday afternoon, I have been engaged in a very strange dialogue with the two Noble Lords, in the course of which I've been trying to bring to their attention the willing availability of a strange organisation which wishes to make a great deal of money available to assist the recovery of the economy in this country. For want of a better description of their name, I'll call them Foundation X.
Well, good morning, Mr. Van Rompuy. You've been in office for 1 year, and in that time, the whole edifice is beginning to crumble. There's chaos. The money's running out. I should thank you. You should perhaps be the pin-up boy of the Eurosceptic movement. But just look around this chamber this morning. Just look at these faces. Look at the fear. Look at the anger. Poor old Barroso here looks like he's seen a ghost. You know, they're beginning to understand that the game is up. And yet, in their desperation to preserve their dream, they want to remove any remaining traces of democracy.
Kind of occasion where the crisis calls into question old certainties and minds are more open to change. These are very special moments, and they are not happening every day. We have to understand that it's really one of those moments where there is some higher plasticity, and then when we can.
Was introduced to 20 weeks ago last week by a very eminent city firm, FSA controlled. Its chairman who came to me, and its chairman said, "We have this extraordinary request to assist in doing this major financial reconstruction. It's mega bucks, but we need your help to assist us in understanding whether this business is legitimate." So the point is that I was, in the course of doing this very strange activity, I got a very interesting set of phone numbers and references which I could go to for help when I needed it. And so people in the city have known that if they want to check out anything that looks at all odd, they can come to me and I can press a few phone numbers and get a reference. And so they came to me and asked me whether I would get them a reference and a clearance on Foundation X. And for 20 weeks, I've been endeavouring to do so. I myself have come to the absolute conclusion that they are completely genuine and sincere, and that they are quite directly wishing to make the United Kingdom one of the principal points for which they will use to disseminate their extraordinary great wealth into the world at this present moment as part of an attempt to seek the economic recovery of the global economy.
And we had the Greek tragedy earlier on this year, and now we have the situation in Ireland. Now, I know that the stupidity and greed of Irish politicians has a lot to do with this. They should never, ever have joined the euro. They suffered with low interest rates, a false boom, and a massive bust. But look at your response to them. What they're being told, as their government's collapsing, is that it would be inappropriate for them to have a general election. In fact, Commissioner Wren here said they had to agree their budget first before they'd be allowed to have a general election.
And this is such a strange situation. So both the Noble Lord Sassoon and the Noble Lord Strathclyde both came up with what should have been an absolute killer argument as to why this could not be true and we should forget it. Noble Lord Sassoon's argument first was that these people were offering evidence, or they claimed evidence, that they had lodged £5 billion with British banks last year. And they gave dates, and they gave transfer dates, and the details of these transfers. And as Noble Lord Sassoon said, if that was true, it would stick out like a sore thumb. You couldn't have £5 billion popping out of a bank account without it disrupting the balance sheet completely.
Your obsession with creating this Euro state means that you're happy to destroy democracy. You appear to be happy for millions and millions of people to be unemployed and to be poor. Untold millions must suffer so that your Euro dream can continue.
But I remember that about the same time that those transfers were being made, the Noble Lord Miners was indulging in his game of rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic of the British banking community. And if he had had three banks at that time, which had had, say, a deficiency of £1.5 billion each, then you'd pretty well have absorbed the entire £5 billion and you wouldn't have the sore sum stick out on this at that time, because you'd have put £1.5 billion into each of three banks and you'd have lost the lot, or absorbed the lot. That would be a logical explanation. I don't know. Noble Lord Strathclyde came up with a much different argument. He said, this cannot be right. This cannot be right because these people said at the meeting with him that they were still effectively on the gold standard from back in the 1920s, and that their entire currency holdings throughout the world, which were very large, were backed by bullion. And the Noble Lord Strathclyde came back and said to me, he's had an analyst working on it, and this has to be stuff and nonsense, because he said they had come up with a figure for the amount of bullion that would have been needed to cover their currency reserves as claimed, which would be more than the entire value of bullion that had ever been mined in the history of the world. I'm sorry, but the Noble Lord Strathclyde is wrong. His analysts are wrong, because what he had done was he had tapped into the sources which are available, and there is only one definitive source for the amount of bullion that has ever been taken from the Earth's crust, and that was a National Geographic magazine article 12 years ago. And whatever figure it was that they quoted was then quoted again by six other sites on the internet, on Google, and so everybody is quoting one original source, and there is no other confirming authority. But if you tack into the Vatican accounts of the Vatican Bank, you come up with a claim of total bullion.
The Noble Lord is into his 15th minute. I wonder if he could draw his remarks to a conclusion.
The total value of the Vatican Bank reserves would claim to be more than the entire value of gold ever mined in the history of the world. Now, my point on all of this is that we have not proven any of this. Foundation X are saying at this present moment that they are prepared to put up the entire £5 billion for the funding and creation of the 3i recreation. The British government can have the entire independent management and control of it. They don't want anything to do with it. There will be no interest charged. And by the way, if the British government would like it as well, if it will help, they will be prepared to put up money for funding hospitals, schools, the building of Crossrail immediately with £17 billion transfer by Christmas if requested, and all these other things. These things can be done if wished, but we have to have a senior member of the government has to accept the invitation to a phone call to the chairman of the company concerned, Foundation X, and then we can get into business. And all I'm asking is that this is too big an issue. I'm just an ageing, obsessive old peer, and I'm easily dispensable, but getting to the truth is not. And we need to know what really is happening here. My Lords, we must find out the truth of this situation.
And you believe that this is a genuine offer and not a hoax?
I've been working on this now with them for 21 weeks.
They have not put a foot wrong in 21 weeks. They have never contradicted themselves or said anything which would give a lie to anything that they have said. And therefore, from that point of view, I am progressively comfortable with the genuineness of their approach.
A new partnership of nations has begun, and we stand today at a unique and extraordinary moment. The crisis in the Persian Gulf, as grave as it is, also offers a rare opportunity to move toward an historic period of cooperation. Out of these troubled times, our fifth objective, a new world order.